Now, overall, I love my EK, but in the condition that it's currently in, there are certain things that are just really annoying at the moment. Now, I'm not here to just be a complainer. I want to show you guys what those problems are for me, and then we'll come up with a plan to address them in later episodes.
And here we go. Hey. I'd like the spicy chicken sandwich, please.
Not even the sheer deliciousness of the spicy chicken sandwich can distract me from this first annoyance.
Thank you. You too.
Ever since my last incident, where a pickup truck decided to scrape alongside of my car as it was backing out of a parking lot, has my window ever been the same.
Thank you.
My pleasure, bro. Have a great day, okay?
You too.
Woohoo! Spicy chicken.
Yeah, do that. Yes. All right.
Spicy chicken, you are so good.
Hey, man. Cool hat.
Thank you. It'd be a lot cooler if the window roll up.
As a result of having the window off its tracks, I now have a lovely whistle to listen to as I'm driving down the highway. So that leads me to the second annoyance, which kinda just came out of nowhere. What is that? The stick on my column decides to break, and now my windshield wipers just freak out whenever I hit a good bump. Hit a big bump in the road, then I'm fiddling with my stick. How do you not attract weird looks from other drivers with that? But this one's kind of a double whammy, because when I hit those bumps, my mirror falls as well. Not every time will it fall all the way, but it constantly is moving down little by little, and I always have to move it back into place. This happens a lot. And the last annoying thing that I'll talk about in this video can be summed up by pulling this visor down. Interior degradation. Every time I pull this visor down, 20 plus years of dust falls in my face.
Gonna slowly lower this thing. Slowly. But it still has the dust.
Now, if you followed the progress of this car so far, you know that my car has a good side and a bad side. This is the good side, and this is the bad side. Now, the first thing we'll address here again is this window, and it is a direct result of this. This one definitely was a bummer. I work in an office park where all of us employees always park in the same spot every day. Well, normally I park next to this guy who has this really small hatchback, just like I do. Well, I show up one day, and all of a sudden there's this really big truck. I'm like, huh, I don't know who that is. The end of that day comes, and a knock is on the door. And the guy's saying, dude, I'm sorry, I scraped alongside your car with my brand new truck. He's still learning to drive that thing, obviously. But this is what I'm left with, and the direct result of that is having pushed in my door, and it messed up my window too. So as a direct result of that, this window is really messed up. I don't even want to go ahead and use the crank again right now. I pretty much just leave it up all the time because it really is a pain trying to get this thing back up, as you saw in that clip. You can kind of see it here, how the window is just off. You see how the tint is not where it should be? Even how that guy's all pinched up in there. You see how the window just kind of totally moved, even all the way through here. The window just totally moved inside of there.
And so now I know I obviously could pull this panel off. We can get inside there, put it back in its place, and then go ahead and put everything back together. I don't think I'm gonna do that just yet. As you all may or may not know, we may have some paint stuff going on with this car. Maybe sooner than later, I don't know. I got some things in the works. What I'm thinking is I may just go ahead and replace this whole door. And if you've all been on this channel for a while, you know my friend Trav, he actually has a spare door sitting at his house with the window crank and the window works and everything. So I may be picking that up from him, and then we'll get everything ready for when we go to paint the car.
The next thing that I'll address is super annoying. Anytime I hit a bump.
And well, I shouldn't say anytime I hit a bump, because that's not true. It's really when I hit those real good violent bumps. And since my car is lowered on a little bit stiffer suspension, everything really kind of jolts a little harder, you know. And so I don't even really know how it happened, man, but I went to go ahead and use the windshield washer fluid, and boom, the stick kind of just cracked on me. And I remember being like, what the heck? And of course, as that happened in that moment, the windshield wipers start going nuts. And I'm like, what is happening? I'm like, I'm trying to push the thing back into place and it won't go. As my windshield wipers are just freaking out, you know, in normal daylight, I feel like a total freak. There's no rain outside in that moment. And everyone around me, I feel like, is just looking like, what is this guy doing? Windshield wipers just going. So it's just this stick here, man, and I swear if you like look at it wrong, it's just gonna fall. It kind of just falls down and then it gets stuck there and you kind of got to just push it back up and eventually it just catches into place. But in the meantime, the windshield wipers are freaking out. But so here, drawer O parts. And what I got going on is this guy. Now this one is actually for my EG here, but essentially I'm going to need to go get the same thing at the junkyard. This little stick right here, this piece, I think I can go ahead and just take this stick. So I need to find one from an EK and then we'll go ahead and replace that because that has been super annoying. And so actually when I do hit a big bump, it's kind of a double whammy because not only does that stick fall and the windshield wipers go nuts, but the mirror falls. I don't know if you guys saw, but in that clip, the mirror just falls. Every time I hit a nice big bump, oh man, it gets just like annoying constantly moving that thing back and forth. So as you guys see here, I've already been to the junkyard and I found this nice mirror. It seems to hold position really well, so I'll be replacing that here soon. Now you've all heard me talk about the EK interior before. It's something that I don't necessarily love, but I don't hate it either. Like I think it's totally fine. The seats just are what they are. The dash, I think it's kind of cool actually. It's a symbol of the 90s for sure, but it's just clean and simple and I like that. I'm fine with it. But so this next annoying part that I'm gonna show you, I'm just gonna go ahead and sum it up as interior degradation.
This I think is gonna be one of my big jobs here coming up pretty quick. From a distance, the interior looks fine, right? Like it doesn't look bad, and I guess it really isn't, but it is. When you go ahead and look at stuff like this, like the headliner is just totally chewed up, and that kind of just naturally happened. Like, who grabs up there? No one. So it kind of is just falling apart. Same with this side, but you know, this right here is an obvious super bad thing. Man, these folding mirrors. I went ahead and robbed the one from the passenger side. That's actually what this one is over here. And wouldn't you know it, more recently, the mirror actually fell off.
And you guys saw, every time I go ahead and pull that thing down, man, it's like dust. It just rains dust. And I just feel like I'm breathing in like the past 20 years of nastiness that's been in this car. Like, it's just like, I don't know how it translated onto camera, but dude, I can physically see the dust falling. And sometimes I even grab a chunk of the cloth off of the thing. Like, those need to be replaced.
But wouldn't you know it, dude, those things are expensive. I guess because people know that this happens and, you know, people want to replace their sun visors, you can get a brand new one of those things for $150. $300 for the pair.
So I don't really know what I'm gonna do on that front yet. Man, $300 for the pair of those things, that kind of makes me want to throw up.
But so not only is the headliner in pretty rough condition, you see it's kind of sagging there in places too. The back actually is relatively fine. It's mostly up front. But the interior carpet is bad. I don't even know what happened on this side, but look at that. Yo.
Now, when I first bought this car 8 years ago or whatever it is now, it was like this already. So I don't even know. Someone spilled something really gnarly. Maybe someone died there. I don't know. It's bad though.
So covering up that nastiness is actually these really nice Civic Type R floor mats that Travis had given me. He bought these a while ago for his EK, but he ended up taking them out because you're not allowed to have floor mats on track, so he had no more use for them. But in reality, these floor mats have seen better days as well. They're getting a little worn. Y'all see how this side is definitely different. It at least resembles more of the stock color over here, a little bit. But so this carpet here, I definitely plan on changing out.
And so that probably leads us on to the biggest overall annoying thing, and that's the fact that my car has two sides. One side that's good, one side that's not good. I'm not really including that in that list because that's a no-brainer. That's super obvious. Like, I want to get this car painted, and in fact, I've already been in contact with someone. I am in the stage of a little bit of a waiting game at this moment, but that's okay because I need to collect some pieces. I need to collect some pieces for this car or maybe change things up a little bit. So I'm really excited about that. But yeah, I mean, who wouldn't be annoyed by that? You know, your car looks super rough on one side and okay-ish on the other. The interior, I'm gonna be changing out the carpet. I'm gonna change out the headliner, those folding mirrors. I'm gonna figure out something to do with that. I don't know. But I really would just wanna totally freshen up the interior. Seats are likely gonna stay the same. Back seats look good, front seats look good. I'll just give them a nice deep clean. But that carpet is gonna be changed out, headliner as well. I've got some samples coming and I'm gonna be picking them out. And that brings me to a point, y'all should check out my Instagram. You're like, what? What are you doing if you're not on there? Check out our Instagram. I'm gonna be posting up the samples that I get for the carpet and headliner, and I definitely like y'all's opinion. But so this list was super specific to my car, my problems. I'm not talking about Civics in general. So I am absolutely gonna be addressing these problems. I have stuff coming, it's all in the works. If you are not subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe. That way you can follow this journey. We're taking this car from where it's kind of been, you know, on the downside a little bit, and we're bringing it back up. We're making it nicer again. Go ahead and subscribe to our Instagram as well. You can see some of that behind the scenes stuff. And yeah, thank you all so much for watching. Talk to you in the next one.